What are you even doing over
what?
There?
What are you even trying
to do? Doubling's not even really playing.
Whatever the fuck I want.
Well.
Alright.
Are we all in?
Now that I've gone through the... mm-hmm. Now that I've gone through the tedious process of shuffling
the commander deck.
You may
need to give John a little bit more room over there.
Alright, so how are we doing? Are we the same mulligan as last time?
Yes.
Yeah,
we'll have to figure out whoever's
going
first.
What's the mulligan?
For commander rules, the mulligan works. You can draw 7 cards, and then you can take any number of those cards and put them down, and then draw that number minus 1. So, like, let's say you're like, I don't like these 4 cards. You can draw 3, and then you can repeat that process as many times as you want.
I see. All right, I got 38. Roll them D100.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
99.
Shit.
All right.
Good luck.
I'm gonna assume no one's
gonna do that. Going first.
54. Oh, anybody cutting my deck?
No.
I mean, you got the highest score you possibly get without even a.
There's 100 on there. You do the
100.
That's not it.
That's 101. What are you talking about?
All right. So Newton's first. Draw 7.
Move over just a little bit.
Yep. Four, yeah, Chad's already said, like, they can't really see each other.
I'm trying.
Okay.
Trying to back up a little
bit. I'm going to keep this, actually. All 7 cards right here.
You know, last time you did that, you got mana screwed, right?
I didn't do that last time.
Oh, you didn't?
No, I mulled 4 cards, and I drew no lands out of it. It was terrible.
Oh. I'll try this. Okay. I thought it was that you were just like, I'll just take this first.
Not even a little bit.
I'm totally mulliganing, like,
and then first, if you go first, you
all
still
seven
draw.
Cards?
All 7
yes.
cards.
Oh, I see. Janelle's shipping
oh, wow.
7.
Oh, wait. Should I not ship 7?
No, you can keep whichever ones you want. Only ship the ones you want to get rid of, and then draw one less than those. One fewer. Sorry.
Yes. Thank you.
That's better.
I will keep what I have.
You just put them on the bottom, draw your next, your...
Oh, don't
yeah.
shuffle.
Fill up your
don't
hand,
shuffle.
Then shuffle your deck.
Yeah, the idea is that, like, you don't want these cards early, or you don't want them, and so then you just draw again.
What was if I need to do that again?
Ooh,
you
on,
just keep
going.
Keeping
on.
Okay.
Just
keep losing a card.
But you lose the card every time you do it.
Yep,
that's fine.
That's fine. It's Commander.
Look, when you have a hand of 7 lands, and then you pull another hand of 7 lands.
You take it.
You mulligan again.
You want that.
Like, it just, that's just the way it goes.
All right. Butts. Oh, man. I am
Yeah, chat, we are playing the Commander 2014 decks. This is our
keeping it.
Our second round of this, though, so we do have some upgrades. So, John, why don't you explain the upgrade rules that we have assigned for ourselves.
So, seeing as how last time we played with the straight, regular Commander decks, right? This time around...
And we all got stomped by elves.
And we all got wrecked by elves. Except for who died to something other than
nobody.
Elves?
Nobody.
Elves.
To
literally,
literally
yeah.
I literally killed
everybody.
Person.
I thought, oh no, you
nope.
died to elves too.
Yep.
I nope. thought Justin got killed
nope.
by something
nope.
other than
elves. I killed Justin first.
This time, all 4 of us that aren't Janelle will be allying to kill Janelle.
This is no longer a fair game.
And then we'll go home.
Now you all know why I lose at the end.
Anyways, this time around, we allowed up to 10 substitutions out of the 100 card commander deck. None of them could be the commander. You had to keep the same commander. However, they could be any card from basically anything that wasn't banned in Commander.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it could be a card that costs no more than $10
yeah.
on like
TCG
player,
player.
Yeah. Right.
We wanted to do something that was very akin to how most players are probably upgrading their decks. These
right.
are cards that you probably already have in your binder, or maybe something you trade for.
Absolutely.
There are certainly much more powerful commander cards, but
yes.
We wanted to gear a little bit more towards, you know, the middle of the spectrum.
We did. And if you weren't around last time, I'm John Boulding, tabletop games editor here at The Escapist. We'll be playing the part of Teferi, Temporal Archmage, with the blue commander deck, Mono Blue. Mm-hmm. I have with me today Newton Grant.
Yep, Newton Grant, and I'll be playing the white Nahiri, the Lithomancer deck.
And Josh Vanderwall.
Josh Vanderwall, managing editor here at The Escapist. I'm playing the mono red Doretti Scrap Savant deck.
Janelle Bonanno, pleasure meeting you guys. I'll be playing Feralise, the mono green elf deck.
And Justin Klaus.
Hey everybody, I'm Justin Klaus. I'm the senior video editor here. And I am playing Obnixilus of the Black Oath.
Look at the camera.
Ooh. And we are sworn to darkness.
sworn to darkness.
And black mana.
Darkness.
Darkness.
Darkness. Ermigerd.
All right, so Newton, you roll the highest, so you are going first.
Right.
You do draw because we are more than four people.
I see. All right. Well, I will go ahead and do that.
Is that only a more than four people rule?
Yeah, so technically the multiplayer rule is that if you have more than four, the first person still draws. If you have three, then you're not supposed to.
Okay.
Yeah. So I will play a plane, and I will pass the turn. That was easy.
It's a great turn. I'll play an island and pass the turn.
The lands coming down.
All the lands.
Two entire lands.
Uh-oh, that's the third one right there.
I'll play a soul ring.
Oh, God.
Again?
Stop it!
No!
I am going to play an Evolving Wilds and Kraken for a land.
I assume she's going to get
up. That's not your graveyard. That's your command zone.
Oh,
yep,
sorry.
There you go.
Thank you.
Command zone.
Are you done after that?
Yep.
All right. I'm going to draw a card. Ooh, neat. I'll play a mountain.
I also technically broke the rule because I broke out some of my foil swamps.
I'm
sorry, you're DQ'd.
I quit.
Wait, a foil swamp is more than $10?
No, but like I exchanged
more than 10 cards.
Either I quit or he DQ'd. One or the other.
I'm sorry, only one of us here is a certified judge at the moment.
Who broke the rules.
I don't care.
Even more egregious that you broke the rule.
I did it to Justin this morning.
Code of conduct.
This morning I stood up from my desk where I was adding my cards to my commander deck, and I walked over to Justin with my hand raised and just went, "Judge," and made him make a rule.
Oh.
Tell me how something works.
Tapped.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. I will play a.
Oh God, another land. Newton's the clear threat, guys.
Yep. He's got two lands.
Oh, now he's really the clear threat.
Yeah, and I will. Play the Swiftfoot Boots.
Okay.
Oh, snap.
Is that in everyone's deck?
More or less, yeah.
Okay.
I don't think it's in mine, actually. But
I believe they're
in
everyone.
Really?
It's like just a
I mean, I know
a
it's a
staple.
Standard staple, but given that our commanders are planes,
you know what that is?
It's a little less imperative.
It's an island.
Yeah.
And then I pass the turn.
All right. And I also drew Swiftfoot Boots for the turn. I'm going to play a Myriad Landscape, comes into play tapped. I can crack it for two and sacrifice it. Go search up some lands. We'll play this Burnished Heart. Who can also go get me lands.
All right,
go ahead.
Lands.
No, lands. Stop it.
Lands.
Damn it.
If only you had some card draw.
This is not
good.
What would that be like?
I don't know.
So I'm going to play a Terramorphic Expanse and crack it?
crack it.
Just over and over again, aren't you? You done after that?
Yeah.
All right.
What is the...
It lets you search for a base land. Oh, hey, funny that.
Comes into play theft. Hey, Josh, you're already off to a better start than you were before.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's going to have their boots in play.
You have proven that this deck does, in fact, have a Swiftfoot Boots.
Nope.
Newton, go right ahead.
All right. Now we need to get some creatures to equip. Can make them happy.
Lands in front.
All right, I will.
Oh yeah, clearly we all have to attack Newton now because he's playing lands in front. As chat has pointed out.
Newton always plays lands in front.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm kind of old school like that. Oh my gosh. So I will go ahead and play a Karu. Enters the battlefield tap. When Karu enters the battlefield, sacrifice it unless you return an untapped plane to control to owner's hand.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And then I can tap it for one colorless and one white to my mana.
Oh. So, Justin,
yeah.
Do you happen to know where the lands in front came from? Like, I've been looking up, I've been trying to find, like, PDFs of old rule books and stuff to see if it was, like, how the layout was presented in the old rule books or whatever. I used to play lands in front
mm-hmm.
for, like, 15 years or something. And it wasn't until I realized just how useful it is to play lands in back that I switched over. But I feel like I had to have gotten it from somewhere.
There's like...
Playing this as a morph, face down.
I don't know if there was a specific thing, but there was definitely a... like different like regions even have.
Blue decks
like
tapped out, guys. Go for the throat.
Go for the throat!
Slightly different styles. I'll play Swamp. I can't attack John. He probably won't trade us more for my Burgess card.
Unless it's a crappy morph.
We'll attack Newton for two.
What? What'd I do?
Yep.
Nope. You attacked the wrong person, Justin.
The wrong person?
That's the wrong color.
The not elves.
The not elves deck.
The not elves, not life gain deck.
Who's got life gain?
I only have one card that gives me life gain.
And Josh only has one card that returns artifacts from his graveyard.
One card.
And you saw how well that went for the rest of us.
One fucking card.
I feel like I'm getting a little too sassy for this early in the game. I'm gonna turn it back.
You're getting pretty sassy.
You have to not present yourself as the threat.
I had a cup of coffee 2 hours ago. I'm drinking a Coke now. It's Friday. That's all I'm saying.
I'm gonna cast Emerald Medallion. Green spells cost one less. And Essence Warden.
That's not Swiftfoot Boots. No. I just want to have like everyone have like
Swiftfoot Boots.
The boots. And
nobody equip it. Just keep them around.
What?
But that's only one green.
Oh, hand. That's two. Okay. So I thought the three were for that. Apologies.
Okay.
Nope, she's good.
God.
Proceed.
I think she's done.
I'm done.
Okay.
It's your turn.
If you're done, I'm done.
I like taking turns. It makes me happy.
I don't like taking turns. John likes taking turns. Especially extra turns.
John likes to take turns. John likes to take extra turns. John likes to take unlimited extra turns.
Commander's Fear.
Oh.
Go ahead.
No.
What does that
Stop
do?
It.
It just adds mana. I can sack a draw card.
I see.
Three mana rocks. It's actually one of the more useful new commander cards I've found. Just because it's like, you have a mana rock early, and then you can pay no cost to like cycle
you
it into
the
card.
Can tap it for mana, then sack it, and all sorts of fun stuff.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Also great for Josh's deck, because it's an artifact.
It
you
is
can
an
send
artifact.
It to his graveyard, and then screw
do
with
things.
It.
I can.
So,
I can indeed.
Yeah, you can like just recur it and get it back.
As a violence in chat has said, that's not true, Josh. There are a bunch of Rieger artifact cards in that red deck.
Ooh. So I'll go ahead and tap the Karoo and a Plains for three to cast the Skyhunter Skirmisher, which has flying and double strike. It's a 1/1.
1/1 flying double strike.
And then I'll pay one to equip the Swift Foot Boots to the Skirmisher, making it hexproof and hasty, and I will hit Janelle for two.
And so begins the downfall of Janelle.
I think you're 30.
The downfall of elves.
Flying double strike.
Start with 40. Yep.
All right.
Not two at a giant.
Is that you? Is that you, Newton?
That's it for me.
Hello.
God, I guess I'm gonna have to kill Newton first.
I agree. We should all
Sapphire Medallion, blue spells you cast cost one less.
What? Already?
I like how this board is mostly like the same cards.
I never got Sapphire Medallion. I really wanted it.
I just mean
time.
Like right now on this actual.
Oh, just the actual like board state. And then I will pass the turn.
Passing it.
On the turn, I'm gonna sacrifice this Myriad Landscape. Go get. Two swamps, put them into play tapped.
Ho ho ho.
Hey,
and then shuffle. This is also actually a pretty good card out of the new, because it's just like ramp that's on a land.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a little time consuming because it's like it comes into play tap and then the next turn you can sacrifice it, but.
Yeah, maybe a little pricey, but.
Still, it's not bad for like.
Right.
Is that your last move?
No, I'm just doing this on the end of his turn.
Oh, I missed that. Okay.
Yeah.
On the end of his turn.
It's one tap. let's even up life a little bit. Josh, you can take two.
I'm all right. Josh takes two. All right. 38.
Take two. And look, I'm going to even take two myself. I'm going to play Obnixilus. I'm going to take him down.
Always the first one to bring out his commander.
What? Already? That's crap, man.
That's fine. I'll make a demon.
That is unacceptable.
We're all done.
No demons.
5/5, yeah?
Yep. Can you hand me my dice?
I might. What's she going to give me for?
I would like to put a counter on this guy. Otherwise, I'm just gonna tell you guys how many counters he has.
He has 13 counters.
Yeah, he's gonna ultimate next turn. What do you think about that?
Go ahead, Janelle.
I'm getting bad draws. What to do?
So Janelle.
Josh.
I would like to point out that you have a creature in play with a passive ability that triggers when creatures enter the battlefield.
I know. When all creatures?
Pay attention to that.
Yeah, I think it's any, whenever another creature.
Oh.
Which is not just creatures you control. So you got 39. 39.
Ugh.
Sorry, I'm
already.
Just one that lets me gain health.
It's not my fault, that's the one I have out right now.
I wish anyone but me had seen that eye roll you just did. Just like, Jesus, Bolding, fuck off. Oh,
yeah. I'm good with the faces. I don't need to say much usually.
And then, somebody in the chat is asking how good do you think the medallions are? In my opinion, they're fine, but not super great. Most of the spells you play in Commander tend to be more expensive. So, you know, they're really better if you were like playing multiple spells in a turn, which usually you're not getting to.
Yeah.
I will disagree. I will actually disagree with you for that exact reason, which is, in my deck, it's invaluable.
Mm-hmm.
Because having the spare, like, little one or two mana to play a couple five or six mana cost spells in a blue deck is just wondrous. So I'm already staring at my hand and saying, like, ha 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 ha
ha. Yeah.
Right?
I guess the question is, like, is it better than just playing, like, another mana rock of some kind? Something that's just like, I tap for X amount of mana.
I don't think so.
I feel like for Janelle's deck specifically, and maybe John's deck, I haven't looked into that so mm-hmm. much, but she plays a lot of spells as frequently as possible.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And so having the mana reduction is much better than a single mana available. Just because, you know, you get to play an Archdruid and a Priest of Titania
right.
and
yeah.
The stupid
you can keep
Tramper guy.
I'm going to play Hunting Triad, which yeah. gives me 3/1/1 green elf creature tokens.
Okay.
What?
And then that's
good. I'm totally with you, Josh.
Be the end of my turn.
I have a lot of like.
And then I get 3
4 elf. And 5 cost spells. And therefore, that Sapphire Medallion is probably a little more valuable than a mana rock over time.
Hmm. Interesting. Very, very interesting. Okay, I'll play a Buried Ruin.
What? Lets him get artifacts back.
Yeah, I can sack it to reclaim an artifact from my graveyard to my hand. And then...
I don't know why. Why would Derebi ever want to get artifacts back from the graveyard?
It's not clear to me, but I'll let you know if I figure it out.
Okay, then I'm going to cast Pilgrim's Eye. 1/1 flying when it enters the battlefield. I may search my library for a basic land card, reveal it, and put it in my hand, then shuffle my library.
Shuffle it.
I'm going to grab this here.
It.
Mountain on the bottom.
Mountain! Sorry, that's my mountain voice.
I
have a mountain Newton. Voice.
Actually, before end of turn, I guess during my second main, I will equip that and then not attack. Go ahead, Newton.
Okay.
For a really long time, I thought saying mountain like that made my voice really deep and intimidating. And it took a while, but Josh eventually told me that it did not.
That is what a spouse is for.
I will play a mountain.
Mountain!
That spouse is a four.
telling you, I'm sorry, no one is impressed.
No.
There's not impressive
sorry,
just, thing about
no.
you.
I'm going to break this to you as lightly as I can. That sucked.
All right. I am going to...
God, stop thinking about attacking me, Newton. I can read your damn mind.
Stop thinking about attacking her and just attack
you,
her.
You can put her back to her starting life total.
She what? Get out.
Yeah,
she
got
42?
Yeah, because she gained 1 when the demon came into play, and then she gained a whole bunch when she played her elves, then another 1 when Josh played his dude. Miss Trigger.
I'm the queen of Miss Triggers.
Uh-huh.
If there's one problem I have in Magic the Gathering, it's Miss Triggers. Like, I'm just like the queen of that.
2 turns later. Oh, man.
Man, that's tough. All right. Let's...
Says the guy. Yeah. Put her back to her starting life total, says the guy with the 5/5 demon out.
Hey, wait, yeah.
You also have, what, 4 power on the board? Not like you're, like, that far behind me.
4 power that clearly isn't flying.
So, like, not like that matters, but, like, Josh has a little, like, little floating artifact dude.
Yep. Okay.
Newton's got a cat.
All right, stop.
Not a dragon.
Stop.
All right, I'm going to cast Mobilization.
All right.
Which means that soldier creatures have vigilance. And I can tap 2 colorless and a white to put a 1/1 white soldier creature token onto the battlefield. That's it. For now.
Hey, Fiditai in chat, you say you're new to the game. New to Commander or just new to Magic in general? He's looking for good advice or tips for someone that's new. But you guys can keep it.
Yeah, knowing whether he's new to the game in general or
yeah, if you're looking for stuff for like so for Commander, we're actually gonna have an article going up later today of like what are the changes we made and basically giving some of the ideas of like, you know, how we think about Commander and stuff like that. And John has already forgotten what his morph is.
I'm considering if I want to use my morph.
In John's defense, he forgot what his morph was 3 turns ago when he played it. He just didn't care until right now.
I was like, oh, it's a morph. Threw it on the table. All right. I'm going to go ahead and tap 4 to play a Storm Surge Kraken. This is a 5/5 with hexproof. It also has the Lieutenant ability, which means if my commander's on the board, it has +2/+2, and if it is blocked, I draw 2 cards.
Okay.
And then I will pass the turn to Justin.
That's pretty good.
He's just hexproof. He's not flying, right?
He's not flying.
No,
he's only
but
hexproof.
He gets a bunch of advantage if you do block him.
Wait, he's 5/5 hexproof for 4?
4 with Sapphire Medallion.
Oh, I see, yeah.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Yes, it is.
Well, we don't have anything else to do, so we're going to take up Obnixilus. So everybody loses 1 life, and then I gain life. Where's 42?
I remember this.
Yes, I also remember this.
Look, after I've ticked him down, there's only one direction he can go. We're going to play this with foot boots. I announced earlier that I had it. I said, oh, look, I drew the Swiftfoot boots that turn.
I thought it was very funny that you have Swiftfoot boots.
Yep. We'll attach it to the demon. Newton's dead. Your flyers are annoying.
I haven't attacked anyone but Janelle.
No, but I need to, like, keep Obnixilus protected. I will pass the turn after.
Double striker.
I like where that went. That was nice.
Fiditai, for Magic in general, I would highly recommend either checking out like your local gaming store. Usually they'll have like a casual night on Wednesdays, which is really good. If you're just getting into Magic, a lot of stores will have like a donation box. So like if you're just looking to like try and build some decks, you can usually like just pick up a bunch of cards from there. I know Atomic has one that are just like the only limit is like a handful. If you just want to take, you know, as many cards as you want out of there, you know, you're welcome to.
I imagine a lot of local game shops will have the little starter decks from Wizards of the Coast too. The
yeah.
To play decks.
Yeah, those are pretty solid.
And they contain rares now, which is pretty fancy.
Oh, yeah. Now those starter decks are like 40 card decks though, right?
I think they're 30 actually.
Yeah.
They're not even like limited size decks.
They're a nice way to like get in on the game.
Learn the rules, get a handful of cards you can like assemble stuff with.
Damn it. I'm gonna put down a land.
You sound so sad about that.
Put it down.
I am a little sad. Because I want to do more than that, but I don't think I should. I always struggle with decks like these. Mm-hmm. Like between strategy and overcommitting yourself, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Like anything that's really creature heavy, I always struggle with.
Commander tends to be much more board state dependent. You want to put things on the board. There are more wraps, but they're kind of affecting everybody equally. So.
Okay, I'm done.
Okay, there we go. Big money, awesome stuff. Yeah? No.
Big money.
Okay.
Whammy.
Awesome
big
stuff.
Big money, awesome.
Should ask for no whammy.
Big money. Yeah. Well, awesome stuff.
Well, luckily, if you don't like the cards in your hand, Derevi can help you with that.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. Is that his commander name?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And his plus ability is just like loot. Actually, it's rummage, not loot.
Loot, loot, loot.
Hit the discard first.
But. Okay, so play the land. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. Here we go. Scuttling Doom Engine.
So this is one of the new cards you've added, probably.
Christ, Vanderwall.
Scuttling Doom Engine. 6/6, 4/6. Pretty decent. Scuttling Doom Engine can't be blocked by a creature with power 2 or less. Nice little bonus. And when he dies, it deals 6 damage to target opponent, which should be noted can be redirected to their planeswalkers. Newton, go ahead.
It's on now. What are you talking about?
What are you saying, Bull?
I'm not saying anything. I'm not trying to imply.
Is there something I may have missed here?
Are you implying something?
I don't know. I just can't say anything. I'm not like pointing out a tar. I wouldn't do that.
How much does Freya cost again?
5.
Who?
Your commander.
Mine?
Yeah.
5. 4 with the Emerald Medallion.
She's cheap. She's pretty good.
Yeah. I'm puzzling as to, you know, what Janelle would keep up in her hand rather than her commander to play.
Oh, interesting.
That has to be something good.
I'll try this. I'll put down Mentor of the Meek. Whenever another creature with power 2 or less enters the battlefield under my control, I may pay 1. If I do, I draw a card.
Well, that's a pretty good one for you.
Yeah. I'm not dissatisfied with that one.
Especially since your commander makes 1/1s.
Yes.
I'm gonna make a dude. I'm gonna pay a man. I'm gonna draw a card.
So I will pass a turn.
Gets even better with Skull Clamp. Then it becomes pay 1 mana, attach Skull Clamp. And then you just draw 3 cards every time you take up Nahiri.
Oh, that's a good one.
Because it enters play, it'll trigger the mentor, you get to pay for the mentor, and then as part of the ability, you get to attach Skullclamp to it. And so, like, Skullclamp makes a die, you draw 2 cards, and then you draw off the mentor. Yeah. It's fun.
What's the total power you have over there, Justin?
7?
Okay. Butts. Tap 5 to play Teferi.
Weird. I have another target now.
Tick Teferi up.
Up to 6, eh? How weird.
You're really getting saucy, and I don't like it, okay? Tick Teferi up to do the thing.
What does she do?
Teferi gives me the ability to look at the top 2 cards in my library, put 1 on the bottom, and 1 in my hand.
Pretty nice ability.
It is a pretty nice ability.
It is pretty nice and pretty.
Put down
nice
an Island. And then, you know what I'm gonna do?
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do?
Going to pass the turn to Justin.
All right, editor. Sacrifice Prime Strike. Because suddenly he can't block anybody. Stupid Scuttling Doom Engine. Can't even jump block with my Burnished Heart.
Glad I removed all the low power creatures from my deck.
Whenever dies. Scuttling Doom Engine. Alright.
Big money. Nope. I'm gonna attack you, Newton, with the 5/5.
5/5 flyer.
Five in the air. It's
funny, it's like just
wave them like you just don't care.
Yeah, that's nice. I'll take it.
You're on.
down up next list, lose two. Put on a demon.
Did you end up putting Obnixilis as a demon in your deck?
No, I kind of wanted
have.
To. You
should have.
I ran out of cards. Like, I actually found that like the 10 cards was really interesting because there was a bunch of things.
You're a bad role player.
There was a bunch of like synergy things I would have loved to put in, but like I just didn't have like enough available cards to do the things I really wanted to.
That's funny. Yeah. I only swapped out 5 cards. Like, I didn't even need all 10. I was just like, you know what? This deck does mostly what I want it to do.
Yeah. I wanted to rehaul my deck, but it required
more
than I really wanted it, that I was really capable of doing.
Yeah. I basically cut out a sub-theme my deck had and put it in a different
way. Yeah.
I'm going to play Disciple of Bolas. We're going to sacrifice our demon. Game 5 life.
Wonderful.
And draw 5 cards.
What does that do?
So when Disciple of Bolas enters the battlefield, sacrifice another creature, you gain X life and draw X cards, where X is that creature's power. let's see, where he played land this turn.
So am I.
We'll pay 2. Put a charcoal demon. Or charcoal thing into play. Charcoal demon.
It's more or less a demon.
Put that. Play a flesh carver. He's a 2/2 intimidate. I can pay 1 and a black to sacrifice another creature and put 2 counters on him. And then when he dies, I get a XX black horror creature token, where X was his power.
Oh. All right, this is bad.
Justin's getting really scary.
Nothing's changed. I still have 1 demon in play and like 2 2/2s.
I don't know.
Go ahead.
I see a snowball effect going on here.
Damn it. All right, that wasn't what I wanted. Hmm. Good to know.
That was not what you know.
Good to know. So I'm going to cast Feralise. And tick her up.
Tick her up, tick her up.
Make it elf. Weird noises coming from the ceiling.
Here's
weird,
your Josh.
Weird watery noises coming from the ceiling.
Yeah, ocean, that's what's super great for us.
Whenever there's water coming from the ceiling,
yeah.
You hear the sound, I get nervous.
Okay, here's what's gonna happen, guys.
Here's what's gonna happen.
What's gonna happen? What's gonna happen?
I'm going to attack.
Oh no.
Okay.
Coming at Obnixilis with the Scuttling Doom Engine. Okay.
Oh! Obnixilis took it in the cheek.
That.
Well, I can't block with either of these two guys. I'm not going to just like throw my demon in front of it.
Fire Diamond. 1, 2, 3. Duretti.
Are we gonna start
As a response, I'm gonna to casting Duretti, I'm gonna go ahead and sack the Commander Sphere to draw a card.
I like that.
And then I will +2 Duretti, sack the Doom Engine to get the Commander Sphere back.
I like where this
is
going.
-2, sorry, not +2.
Oh. I know where this is going.
I'm not dumb. And I'll kill Teferi.
Okay.
6 damage.
Bonk.
Oh.
All right. Oh, and then God. I will pass the turn.
That's scary.
Go ahead, dude.
Oh, snap.
Yeah, you don't want that.
Oh, snap.
Nothing to see here, folks. Move along.
There's a lot to see there. It's obnoxious.
Everybody remember to put lots of Exile Graveyard effects into their decks, right?
I might have.
Once I saw Josh put a card in his deck specifically to screw with me, I might have put a couple cards
in
my deck
specifically to screw with you. That was that was merely a side benefit. It is primarily so I can take an extra turn.
There may or may not have been some, like, so, like, we're trying to put this artificial together today of what cards we're swapping in and out, and there may or may not have been some chicken being played of, like, who was going to reveal what cards they were putting in.
All right, I'm going to tap one to move the Swiftfoot Boots over to my Mentor of the Meek.
Okay, that seems like a pretty good one to protect.
I should have done that last turn. And I will pass the turn.
Okay.
How much does it cost you to put a soldier into play with mobilization?
Three.
Okay.
How many creatures you got over there, Josh?
One.
What is it?
It's a 1/1 flyer.
It's not very big.
Fuck it.
It has hexproof.
That's really cute.
That's all right.
I'm going to tap four to play Thran Dynamo.
Okay.
What's Thran Dynamo do?
It is a tap to add three colorless to your mana pool.
Okay.
But it doesn't untap unless you pay four.
Okay.
So no, it's like wait, a, just...
Or am I thinking of a different card?
You're thinking of a different
card.
Oh,
I'm thinking of...
this is just a three mana mana rock.
Okay, never mind. One of the monuments or something like that. Crap.
That's, no. It was like Manivolt used to do that, right? Something like that?
No, Manivolt was the one that was like, you take damage. Crap, I'm like forgetting the name of this card. It's in a lot of commander decks.
Hmm.
Oh, well.
Anyways, declare attackers. Swinging at the ready for five. That creature is hexproof.
It also has another ability.
Yeah, I know.
What's the other ability?
You know what?
Basically unblockable.
He's not
but...
that good.
There you go. Just for you, John.
You have made planeswalkers everywhere. Breathe a sigh.
Grim Monolith, that's it.
Pass the turn to Justin.
Okay.
Planeswalkers everywhere feel safer.
They do. And more expensive. Why did you do that
to
me, Josh?
You're welcome, John.
You don't like me very much, do you?
I thought you just liked spending mana.
I do like spending
mana. I thought you just liked spending mana.
Spending the mana, spending it well. Spending it like you just don't care or something.
That's very good news.
Alright, we're going to go ahead and play one of the cards I added to this deck, which was Neverall's Disc.
Oh, good.
Wonderful.
Just because I have no way of dealing with like artifacts and enchantments. So it's 4 mana, comes into play tapped, and then I can pay 1 tap and destroy all... artifacts, creatures, and enchantments.
Whoa. Destroy
Hold the
all.
Phone. Hold the phone.
Yes.
Is it bad? It's that bad?
It's pretty bad.
It's pretty bad.
I mean, I'm just using it to make sure everyone else plays nice and fairly.
Which means it's pretty bad.
I'm countering. Dismiss.
Oh.
Is it bad?
Counter target spell, draw a card.
You know, as soon as you do this, though, like... something really terrible, like Josh is going to
I am
play,
aware
like,
that something worse happens as soon as you use your counter spell. I have been playing blue since I started Magic.
Whenever you use your counter spell, something worse always happens.
Murphy's Law of counter spell is whatever you don't get to counter is always worse than whatever you did counter.
Why is it?
The last tournament that Josh and I went to, well, not tournament, it was a pre-release two-headed giant.
Uh-huh.
And we were playing one of the decks we were playing was a blue control that was complementing the other deck. And we had this one like major counter that we've been holding the entire game.
Right.
And they play this devastating search card that lets them draw tons of cards.
Right.
And we countered that. And they immediately play a card that was like the card we didn't want them to draw if they got the
right.
card through. And we were just like, shit.
Oh.
Yeah. Well,
dig through time and
since we're on plan for like not letting anybody keep their commanders in play.
That was the plan?
I'm
who said
go
that
ahead
was
keep
the plan?
Fraelis. Every other commander has gotten into play and died other than Nahiri.
Come out
so
and gotten splatted.
I'm going to attempt to kill Nahiri with this 5/5 demon.
Fine.
In the air, I mean.
Fraelis.
Fraelis,
yeah.
Yeah, like what I was like, well, how is she not even on the board?
She's still getting real aggressive out here.
She's on the command zone. What's up? Isn't that the same place?
Just go ahead.
I'm gonna land
the
in my hands.
It's the base.
We're gonna play a Pontiff of Blight. He's a 2/7. He's got the biggest butt ever. He has extort, and then other creatures I control have extort. An extort is whenever I cast a spell, I can pay one mana, and everyone loses one life, and I gain that much life.
That's unacceptable.
That's unacceptable?
I dislike that.
You can murder it if you have a card. Yep, you get a life. And I will pass the turn. Murphy's Law of Discard. It will always top deck something worse.
I'm going to cast Predator Flagship.
Oh, good. That one.
Oh, fun.
Yeah. To be fair, I never used it once.
You did.
Not in its full capacity.
Oh, like make
something
flying
and
then shoot
it.
Yeah. Yeah, I just happened to have like a bunch of flyers when I was playing Newton's deck. It was really annoying.
Huh. Oh, that's bad. You may want to move the boots. Well, I mean, it is a 1/1 double strike. It's
a pretty good target for all your equipment.
Well, because I just happen to have the mana.
You just happen to have the mana?
I just fucking happen to have the mana. For attacking my planeswalker, Justin. I'm gonna give one of my elf warriors flying.
Alright.
You have no flyers?
Nope.
And then I'm gonna hit you with one of them.
34. 44. Ow.
Take that, jerk!
This tiny little elf runs in front of, like, some weird priest dude, a zombie, and, like, some other guy, and he's just like, yeah, I'm up here. You can't
sucker do punch, bitches. Sucker punch from the sky.
Take it.
Take it hard.
Okay. Yeah. Cool.
You guys done?
I mean, that's all I got. All
right, excellent.
If I had anything better, I bet you I wouldn't have done that. So.
If I had anything better, I wouldn't have done that.
Interesting.
Or never else this.
Oh, that's a little bit hilarious.
You know what's really fun?
You guys did it to mine, so I did it to yours.
Is when you give this indestructible, because it's not a tap and sacrifice ability, it's just a tap ability.
Yeah.
So if your never else disc is indestructible, you just get to like blow everything up every turn.
He
was like, oh, we're going to play the fun police. Is anybody getting out of control?
Bam. You mean my deck? Seems like it at least these days.
Okay, so here's my plan. I think I'm gonna do
surrender.
Oh yeah, you could just concede.
Yeah,
I could do that.
That
seems like a strong move at this point.
That's
in the
a
game.
Plan.
It's not the worst idea I've heard all day.
You could go get a beer.
Are we planning a commercial break?
Four.
Oh,
we
take
on camera.
Yeah.
Trading post. And then
clearly, you've never seen me stream on a Friday, Newton.
There's been a lot of space trucking with beer.
Have you seen me drunken space trucking yet in Elite Dangerous? This is really funny. It's on our YouTube Escapes Plays, and I slowly get worse at docking over the course of the stream. And eventually I find some like explosives.
Don't drink and fly.
Here's the plan.
Don't fly around with explosives drunkenly.
Trading post, sack Pilgrim's Eye, get Scuttling Doomman.
Hi, trading post.
Why don't you want a goat instead?
You should have gotten
goats
a goat.
Are great.
I'll get to goats. Then I'm going to follow that up with a very quick whip flare. Deals 2 damage to each non-artifact creature.
Fucking bitch.
I will respond.
Aww.
Oh.
I will
thanks,
respond.
Justin.
I'm going to eat So Flesh Carver is going to eat this disciple, so he can get some counters and not die.
So you, what is it? 2-2 to each what?
2 damage to each non-artifact creature.
All right, morph goes away.
What was
that's
the
all
work?
Your dudes?
Drying elemental.
Okay.
That'll affect
it forces players to skip their untap steps.
That's not very nice.
Pickles.
Pickles.
There actually was an old deck that was a combo deck based around
brine elemental,
never letting you untap. And yeah, it was
so what did you cast?
I cast nothing. I lost my morph.
Are you doing anything response to this team? Otherwise, you guys are gonna die.
You should make a dude as a response.
That's definitely what you don't want to do. Is Whip Player in the deck or did you add that?
It's in the deck.
Okay.
That makes sense. Screw it. I'll take it.
Whip Player seems like an obvious card for that deck just because you know it's probably going to play against that white deck or that green deck.
You could, if you want to, Newton, like make a dude and draw a card off Mentor if you really wanted to. Do you have 4 mana up?
Isn't Homeboy hexproof? Oh, no, it's a...
Yeah, that's true. I could do that.
Like I said, make a dude as a response.
I forgot about Mentor. That might actually be worth it.
I'll do that. So make a dude, tap one, draw a card, they all die.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
So his dude comes out before people die.
Yes. Yeah, and then his little soldier's going
that down. Is, yes.
Yep, so you're...
All right, I'm done. All right.
Get that life, man. You're he gets right. his guy, he get. I get my life.
He gets his guy, I get my life.
Oh, that's true. Somebody in the chat pointed out the Nevril's disc also doesn't specify planeswalkers. So, like, especially in the...
does not. It's old enough to not.
If you're playing like a planeswalker heavy version...
Need to play a card or two.
That would be good. You should play cards.
So I have a quick question. Mm-hmm. Do we want to do a 1 hour commercial break? Otherwise I need to sneak out real quick.
A 1 hour commercial break? Or
commercial
break at an hour?
It's been an hour now, so I was just wondering if we wanted to do one.
Let's go through the Newton's turn.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I am going to... craziness. Tap that for 4, bring out a Celestial Crusader. Because.
What's that card do?
Yeah, it's Flash with Split Second. Would have wanted to use it. I was considering using it to try to keep folks alive, but then he would have died as well. And then with Flying and other white creatures get +1/+1. And I will go ahead and put the boots on him.
What's its power toughness?
2/2.
Oh, okay.
But now he's hexproof.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
To keep him alive a little longer.
All right.
All right. Cool. We're going to take a quick break, real fast, and we'll be right back.
The RBs.
I'm smashing.
Break all the things.
Break everything. That's what we do on commercial breaks. Just break shit.
That's run around called. The room.
Well, John has everything. Did you get beer?
And we're back.
Should I have gotten
a beer? We are back.
Oh.
Maybe.
Josh is back in just one moment.
Wait.
Okay, well, I'm back, and it's my turn, so I'm going to be back.
We've already been making beer puns. I am obnixless of the beer oath.
I am Teferi, beer-pouring archmage.
I'm Feralise of Lanoir's Blurry.
Beer Savant is actually a pretty easy one there.
Nahiri, the Beeromancer.
Make rocks into beer.
I'm now digging into the Kar's sweet and salty mix.
That's nice. I like that. Sounds delicious.
All right, what you doing over there?
Making decisions, all right?
You got a lot of cards in hand.
That's the idea.
You should not counter my stuff. Just saying.
Or, I should counter your stuff.
Nope. Friendly never all did.
What's the board state look like right now? It's got a 5/5.
It's a lot of empty, because it just
it is
whip flare.
But somehow Justin still has all his creatures.
I'm sorry, mine's got a huge butt. And he's, he's not going to die to a whip flare anytime soon.
Not for nothing, Building. I'm not sure how I feel about this new office manager. This is so not Blue Moon.
Look, Josh, you drank your favorite beer for, I'm going to say, going on a year now, every Friday, and I think it's finally time for us to have something other than Blue Moons. So
Guinness.
There.
I vote Guinness.
Me too.
I can get behind Guinness.
I can get behind Guinness.
That's.
I'm going to go right out to tell Joanna right now. Next time, Guinness.
It's liquid bread.
Tap four, play Urgolem's Eye.
Okay.
What does that do?
It is a 2 colorless mana rock.
Okay.
That's true. Mana. That's how we do around here. And then I am going to tap 7.
More.
Tap 7 to play Teferi.
Again.
And take Teferi up.
He's back.
And he's got the same trick as last time.
Fancy that.
You all done after that?
I am done.
All right.
After that.
I'll go ahead and untap. So that we can play a little bit more quickly.
Playing it quickly.
I'm going to play a swamp. Big surprise. I think Josh was rather mean trying to whip flare everybody's creatures. So we're going to pile on some damage at him.
That's not very nice.
7 and another 4.
All right, so 11?
Yep.
I'll go to 26.
Ooh.
And then,
you know, for the one guy that wasn't really affected by my whip flare, you're taking it awful hard, Justin.
I'm just protecting everyone else. let's see, I'll cost 7. 1, 2, 3, 4. 7. So we're going to cast Omnixilis. Which we're going to extort 3 times.
What does that mean?
So everybody loses 3 life.
You could do his thing 3 times?
So Pontiff of Blight gives everybody else extort.
Oh, okay.
And then I gain 312.
I don't like Justin anymore. He stopped being my friend.
Yeah.
The fact that you thought Justin was your friend means that Justin was playing way better than I thought.
Okay, I didn't actually think Justin was my friend.
All right, we'll make a demon. Give him some boots.
Justin has a lot of demons.
Boot demons.
Go ahead. Yeah, we learned our lesson last time. Like, the default is not tick up on Omnixilis. It's like, oh yeah, I do lose 2 life.
Tick it down.
It's like, make the 5/5. Make the 5/5.
Tick it way down.
Okay.
Like, the last game would have gone way differently had I just, like, ticked him down right away and had the 5/5.
I'm going to pay 2. Well, these are all on top, so I'm doing this backwards. I'm going to pay 2 to cast to Deanna's Chosen. Whenever I play a green spell, put a +1/+1 counter. And then I'm going to pay 3 mana to cast. Wait. Let me do this right. 3 mana.
Chat's making fun of you, John, for living
on the edge. To cast Wolf Caller's Howl.
Having a
who has
open beverage near unsleeved cards.
Well, at the beginning of your
Witches. I live on the edge.
Yeah. Your next turn, that'll proc.
And
Wolves!
What chat doesn't know is that I have an exact copy of this deck still in the box at home.
Cast Beastmaster Ascension.
Beastmaster!
Oh, good.
Oh, yeah. They're all going to be gigantic. I wish I had a Nevril's disc.
In 7 turns from now, but okay.
Talk to me about Beastmaster Ascension, Janelle.
Beastmaster Ascension is
an
enchantment.
Did you add this to your deck?
No, it's in my deck.
Okay.
It's an enchantment, and whenever a creature I control attacks, I can put a quest counter on it.
Okay.
7 or more quest counters on it, my creatures get +5/+5.
Okay, that's nasty.
So I need about 7 attacks.
Dislike.
Yeah. It's not like that deck doesn't put lots of things in play and attack with.
I'm not into that, and I vote against it.
What about the triple extort?
All right.
If you want to...
I'm also against that.
If you want to waste...
I'm also against whatever this is.
I'm against frankly, everything going out of this table.
Everything.
I disagree with all these things, except for
opposed
these,
to all of them.
These things right here, I agree with.
You know what? I'm not even super fond of these things.
I'm done.
Okay. Go all right, here we go. Big money. I'm going to draw something amazing.
To fill in now.
Huh.
I didn't have a land to put down.
Right. I'm going to play a land. I've played a land.
Goat. Goat.
Okay.
Goat.
Quick, faster,
I really want to make a goat. But I
do I need to go get my 60-second sand timer, Justin?
instead, I'm going to...
The timer runs out, you lose half your life.
5. So I'll cast the Scuttling Doom Engine.
Okay.
Then I will...
Yeah, that thing's back.
Whip him. And then I will swing it off Nyxilis.
Down.
And then I will sacrifice him to Trading Post to get an artifact card from my graveyard. Actually, no, I'm going to sacrifice an artifact to draw a card. Sacrifice him, draw a card, kill Teferi. Fuck off.
All right. Aren't you glad I just hit him for a bunch of damage, John?
Yeah, that's on, Josh.
I feel like we should continue this.
Yeah.
Wow.
All right, that's me. All right. Clearly, my role in this game is to screw with people until I die.
Yeah. It just became to screw with people until you die.
Your planeswalkers out of play.
All right. I'm just going to do it.
No.
Tap 5.
Uh-oh.
There you go.
Bringing Nahiri.
She's reasonably safe.
Yes.
Because the scuttling planeswalker murderer is out.
Took her
for
up
now.
2 to bring in a 1/1 core creature. Of course,
Scuttling Doom Engine is the card I would think would actually be fairly low impact in like a normal commander game, but when like you know everyone else is running planeswalker commanders,
it's great.
It's actually much better.
I mean, screwing around and dealing 6 damage every turn is not that bad of a thing either.
Yeah.
I almost
for like a relatively low impact on his actual.
I was thinking about this. I almost feel like with commander, you either have to have like everyone plays a planeswalker commander or everyone plays a creature. Like, I don't feel like the two setups are compatible.
Maybe.
I haven't had too much trouble with it. The
just
time I played it.
One.
Okay. I played it.
And
Atomic.
And pass turn.
Well, the problem is, in my mind, that there's a lot less planeswalker removal than there is creature removal.
Yeah. I guess the counter that is there's just a lot, like,
but it, I mean,
commander board states
tend
to just have things in play, so it's a lot easier to, like, kill a commander Because, like, if enough people are like, we want to get your commander off the board, they just all, like, attack into it. And,
yeah, I mean,
like,
that's with any commander, though.
Yeah. No, but, like, I can't, like, force it's not like Hearthstone where it's true. Like, oh, Kemba's, you know, crazy because she's got all these equipment on her. Like, you can't attack her directly.
Yeah.
Like, it's actually really hard to probably ultimate any of your commanders ever because it's, like, they're all going to be like, oh, your commander's about to ultimate. Like, somebody's got, like, an unblockable creature or a flyer or something. Or just, like, a ton of elves. And they're like, well, I'm going to get at least, like, one or two damage in on them.
Crick. I don't like any of this.
Doesn't None like of any of this. No, he doesn't. He hates it.
All right, I'm gonna play Coral Toll tapped.
Oh, so I can't get it. Oh no, I can potentially get it out of my cards.
And then I'm gonna.
You're getting a lot of wolves off that thing.
Play Dreamstone Hedron.
Do you just have all the Minarachs right now?
I see why the disc. I see why the disc didn't resolve. I think somebody in chat pointed it out too.
Yeah, my deck relies on artifacts for mana.
A billion Minarachs.
Okay.
All done.
Yep.
That's kind of awesome.
I like it a lot. It's a nice card.
I wish I had more mana.
One, two.
I wish I had more whip flares. You probably should.
6, 7, 8, 9.
I'm beginning to know.
Replay up next list. Okay, real expensive. I'll take him down. Make another demon.
Eventually, he will no longer be able to replay
Rob next. He'll simply be so expensive.
We'll put Swiftfoot Boots on him. Josh is being mean, so we're just gonna pile in.
Oh, wow.
Oh, good.
So that's
5, 10,
15, 17, and another 4, 21.
All right.
Does that kill you?
21?
Pretty close.
I'm at 2. All right. Good times.
Maybe you'll stop murdering our planeswalkers.
And then is it my turn?
Yeah, you go.
Okay. So who has 4 cards?
I do.
We all do.
Okay.
You get a lot of wolves. Like, yeah.
I have 5 cards. You get what? 5 wolves? 4 wolves?
4 wolves.
Bark barks.
Puppies.
Well, puppies.
Puppies. Lots of puppies.
Oh, snuggly puppies.
They just want to hug you and be petted and cuddled.
You just want like a dice for them?
Yeah, probably. I was just going to see if there was any more, but there's actually only 1 wolf in my hand.
1 wolf.
We do wolves. Woohoo!
I like how just last turn you're like, I'm never getting this Beastmaster Ascension online. It's going to take me 7 turns.
I mean, it's definitely not going to take at least 1.
I'm glad there's summoning sick this turn. You could actually just like straight kill somebody if they weren't summoning sick. Because they would all attack, they would trigger Beastmaster Ascension.
I thought it required 7.
I thought it doesn't count as long. I thought the damage.
Oh,
would
you need
count
1 more,
before,
yeah. You need a couple more guys, but like.
Yeah, yeah. If you attack with 7 things simultaneously, though, it just does Beastmaster Ascension.
Oh,
yeah, it's just like they're all now triggers. Bigger. Like, it happens right then.
Okie dokie. Are you completely tapped out, Justin?
No, I have 3 mana open.
No, I mean, like, your creatures. Sorry.
Yes.
I'm gonna attack your Omnixilus.
Okay. He's like stupid expensive now.
Well, how much?
It's like plus 6 on top of that.
Oh my
god. 11 mana to play now. It's the 3rd time he's died.
Why did so many demons?
My
Teferi
already cost 10.
It's frightening.
Because I kept making demons.
Each time?
2.
Josh is in 2 health with 0 creatures on the board, John.
That's Josh's fault.
You should kill Josh.
I feel like
too.
You have bigger things to worry about.
No, I just actually don't.
You should throw 1 wolf.
Only 1
down.
Player on this board keeps sabotaging my strategy.
There you go. Oh no, the other one.
There's something sickness.
Oh. I guess that's fair.
What does your 2/7 do? I just want to do this once, so I'm gonna do it.
What? 2/7 what?
He's got extort, and then he gives all my other creatures extort.
And that's the one that lets you reduce everyone's life and gain life?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm going to pay 5 and tap this to give him flying.
He's a flying dude.
And then I'm going to pay 2 to kill him.
Sure.
So no more extort?
Bye, Pontiff.
And then I'm done.
I may have effects at the end of your turn then.
Huh?
I'm just deciding. I may have effects on your turn.
Do it.
What's that do?
He just gets bigger.
I don't know what you're doing.
Who?
Do green spells. Yeah, you're fine. Never mind.
Yeah, he just gets bigger.
Okay, Josh's turn. Taking a turn. Here we go. Big money. Blasphemous act. Right here. Blasphemous act. Big money.
Blaspheme.
That's not blasphemous act.
Don't you blaspheme in here. Don't you blaspheme in here.
Okay. Yes. So I'm at 2. Yeah. That's fantastic. 1, 2, 3, 4. I will bring 5, 6, because he costs 2 more. I'll bring Dreddy back into play.
He's like, yo, what's up? Dude, you're at 2?
Yep. And as my final action,
final. What makes you say
I have very little left. I am going to do this game. I am absolutely confident. So, I'm going to -2 him. Sacking artifact, bring Scuttling Doom Engine out.
Oh boy,
I'm going to sack Scuttling Doom Engine.
The trading post.
To draw a card. Get over there, and I'll kill that guy.
Josh wants to go out having killed everyone's planeswalker at least once.
Oh, wow.
And then I'm going to sack Commander Sphere and draw a card.
There is such a thing
as
being too big of a target.
I'm done.
I guess that's the one downside with this kind of Doom Engine plan is like you're always sacrificing your board state.
In hindsight, I probably could have sacked it in some speed, given that I'm sacking it to Trading Post and like kept a blocker up or something. But your dudes were mostly in the air anyway, so it's not super important.
Well, what does that card do?
Which one?
The one that's tapped.
He gets +1/+1 every time I cast a green spell.
A counter.
Wow.
So it's permanent.
It's crazy.
Dag burn it. Now I can't cast my damn planeswalker. Because I don't have the mana. Ah, screw it.
Sunblast Angel flying. When Sunblast Angel enters the battlefield, destroy all tapped creatures.
Four fights. Flesh Eater's gonna eat the demon.
Nom nom nom.
Okay, that's all I've got.
Destroy all tapped creatures.
Goodbye, tapped creatures.
When he dies, I put a horror into play that's as big as how many counters he has.
Oh,
I'm getting a slightly bigger guy. I also have something else to do. So, how many creatures just died?
One for me.
And I had
1, 2, 3, 4,
and then so another.
Only one for me.
5 total creatures. Down.
5 total. Okay. That's probably worth it. I'm gonna play Spoils of Blood. It's an instant. Put XX black horror creature tokens into the battlefield, where X is the number of creatures that die this turn.
They're 1/1s.
No, you put an XX. I have a 4/4 and a 5/5.
Oh, I see.
Any attacks, maybe?
No.
Really?
What?
You're not gonna kill Josh?
No, I'll
the opportunity of a lifetime.
Wow, really?
I will
swing with your 2/2 flyer and kill Josh.
Yeah. There's not a lot of incentive.
Don't let people convince you that you don't need a blocker.
You've got multiple other blockers.
Yeah, but that means, Newton, if you
don't...
Why don't
you do it?
All I have to say is if you don't kill him, that means John has to waste his attack.
Yeah, I will not kill... I will not kill John.
You're a good man, Newton.
There's no...
Don't let anybody...
No, now we're all just going to wait and we're going to make you do it.
There's no...
She won't. That's the point.
I will.
There's no advantage for me killing Josh right now.
I don't mind being the person.
Remember
to kill
how
Josh.
He just wiped your board 2 turns ago with Whip Flare?
He did.
Uh huh.
You really,
remember that mentro to me? He was gonna go places. You're so turn, many cards.
You're long. You're long. Actually passing the turn.
I am passing the turn.
Long.
How big is Sunblast Angel, by the way?
5-6 right now.
Okay.
Christ.
You got nothing. You got nothing.
I'm drowning in something.
Yeah.
That's what I have to say to you.
Drowning in islands.
Dude, you can pretty much cast anything.
He's got...
No, really. Can I? I guess I'll put more lands on the board.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Is there an omniscience in your hand? Because there should be.
I wonder if there is.
Wait a minute.
I wonder if one of the cards.
$10?
No.
It's far less than $10. It's a 10 mana card. Do you think that gets played in standard formats?
No. It's not even in standard right now.
All right. Well, Newton refused to do it. So Newton pays a price for that.
What?
Two. 3, 4, 5, 6. Playing Phyrexian Ingester, which devours your angel.
Well, what is that?
Gnome.
Your angel's currently a 5?
No, it's a 5-6.
It's a 5-6, so it's going to get +5/+6, and your angel's exiled.
What?
Permanently, or when he dies, is it the angel?
Oh, it's just exiled.
Fresh.
Just gone? That's
for good. I have exiled target non-token creature.
Okay. I just wasn't sure about when the creature dies.
That's not bad.
Nope. So that's now an 8/9. And then, I wonder if Josh has any block. Oh, Josh is tapped out and has no blockers? Is this what it's like to be you? To kill players? Bring the ball down. Well, I guess I have a lot of extra.
This is how you know when someone's not used to killing people, Commander.
Look over it as much as possible.
I will attack with Storm Surge Kraken on Vanderwall for 5. Hexproof.
Is that all you got?
That is what attacks.
Chad is saying it only gets +4/+5. What does the ability say?
Phyrexian Ingester gets +X/+Y, where X is the exiled creature card's power and Y its toughness.
Yeah.
Does not say
it will
base.
Keep the buff, I think, for that. Yeah. Great. Okay. Yoink.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Good luck, Josh. Recasting your commander, sir.
Continue your vacation.
It's exiled power and toughness is what its power and toughness is, not when you exiled it. So it'll be +4/+5.
Okay.
Yeah.
It does not keep buffs that it had, basically, because it was getting that from
Celestial Crusader.
Yeah, the spirit.
Good luck keeping all those planeswalkers in check, guys. That's all I'm saying.
And I'm then going to play...
Oh, you're not dead. Sorry.
Oh, no. Sorry, Justin.
My bad. This is on top of my deck.
How many wolves do you have out, Janelle?
4.
This is a really annoying use of this.
So then don't do it.
I don't want you to get Beastmaster Ascension. Who do I look like?
Janelle is like, hey, Janelle.
I'm just having a conversation. You need a comment, and I responded.
Just leave that there.
It is really that annoying. Don't do it.
You know, I've decided I'm not rooting for elves.
Get them, elves.
Do you want elves?
Actually, they're wolves right now.
So many wolvies.
Good luck.
Josh, no hard feelings, except for the part where I have very hard feelings.
We're very bitter about our commanders dying over and over. Some kind of doom engine.
Oh, that was tough.
Yeah, that was rough, actually. Okay, so I'm going to tap... Oh, that's annoying. 3. Never mind. So I'm going to actually tap
That's the downside of Commander. Trying to like cast your spells with like a billion mana rocks. You're like, all right, this one's out for two. But like, how many of these lands do I want to hold up?
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Play Hoverguard Sweepers and return your two tokens to your hand, Justin.
Two of them? Oh, me. Oh,
hi, guys.
Oh, yay.
That's not very nice.
It was worth it.
That's so mean.
Whoa, you got a ton of shit.
No, I don't.
No, he doesn't.
Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain.
Luckily, Chad, having too many players is kind of a self-depreting problem.
All right, then yep. I pass the turn.
You have a 5/6 flyer and a 4/5. Four five.
Pardon?
No. You have a 7/8, a 7/8 and a 5/6 flyer.
7/8 and a 5/6 flyer.
Wow, dude, that's the brutals.
Who would have thought
Blue's got the biggest creatures on the board now?
That would be that.
Welcome to Bizarro World, also known as Commander.
that'll work. All right.
Blue tends to get like one big creature with a power each set.
Mm. All right. So that is 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. 5, 11. 11 mana. Dregs of Sorrow. Destroy X target non-black creatures, draw X cards. So I'm going to kill those two big guys.
Which two big guys? These two?
The two I can target. One of them's hexproof.
Okay.
So I can't even get them. And then I will kill your four wolves as well, Janelle.
All my wolves?
Yes.
And you can't get my Crusader, because
that was pretty slick.
He's got some. And then so I did that for 6. I'm drawing 6. 2, 5, 6. So much mana.
Are you doing something?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
We suddenly have to accelerate a little bit. We're going to play Cabal Coffers, which is tap 2 and X and tap it, and then add black, where black is the number of swamps I control, which is a lot.
What?
So this is a land. This is one of the cards I added to my deck. It is 2 and tap, and I add black mana to my mana pool equal to the number of swamps I control. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
It's not pretty.
We can do all the things. We're going to play a Bad Moon. For 8, we'll play a Mind Stone.
Did you add Bad Moon to that?
6. Nope, Bad Moon was in the deck. We'll Dread return to 2.
I'm sorry, Justin's too powerful.
Back.
I don't know what's going on
here. He's next, I think.
Pot of a Blight.
Wonderful.
And then pay.
It's Josh's gun.
We'll pay 1 of our remaining floating to equip. And then pay 1 of our remaining floating to sack Mindstone and draw a card. I'm all done.
What is a Bad Moon?
Who has 4 more cards in their hand?
I have 3 cards in my hand.
I have more than 4.
I've got 6.
How many do you have in your hand?
6.
Where my card draw at?
What does Bad Moon do?
It's just Honor the Pure for black creatures. So black creatures get +1/+1.
Oh, I see.
This is terrible.
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 So, I'm going to
Mm-hmm.
sacrifice a land. Here's what I'm gonna do. Let me show you what I'm gonna do before. I'm gonna cast Terra.
Tap some mana, sacrifice a land.
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out which land to get rid of.
It's probably just one of your forests.
You think that's better than getting rid of a colorless?
No, because I mean that can do other things for you.
I guess.
I mean, it's not like you need that many forests.
So.
So the commanders we have, we are playing the Commander 2014 decks, check. So we have the Planeswalker commanders. Red has unfortunately been knocked out of the game, but we still have Omnixilis, Freylies. I always pronounce her name.
Freylies, I think.
Freylies, Nahiri, and Teferi.
Dang, darn it.
And they've all been killed a couple times.
Ugh. And that's why Red is dead, if you've just joined us.
Scuttling Doom Engine is a card when you know that everyone else has Planeswalkers as their commanders, apparently.
So I'm going to do that. And then, before I shuffle my deck real quick, I'm just going to play Llanowar Elves.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. Classic.
Classic. And then I'm going to sacrifice Crystal Vein. No. I'm going to sacrifice...
Oh, the Myriad Landscape?
Yeah.
And go get some more
And go forests. Get some more land.
Okay.
And that costs me two. Plus a tap.
So many cards on the board.
Yeah. That's a lot more land subtly in play for her. Yeah, chat. So the new Commander 2014 product, they specifically printed commanders, other Planeswalkers, and then like... You probably can't see that super well, but the very last line is Omnixilis of the Black Goth can be your commander. I mean, in addition to, like, there's plenty of, like, house-ruled games where people are already like, oh yeah, this is my commander, Jace the Mind Sculptor.
No!
Yeah!
No! This is my commander, Jace the $150 sitting in the middle of the table.
I had a Jace for a while. I, like, bought a pack of, like,
Why
this is back
you
when
have
I,
a Jace anymore?
Because I sold it, and it was part of how I got really back into kind of, like, competitive Magic.
Oh, okay.
I just got this sudden, like, influx of a bunch of money.
A bunch of money.
Yep. Not an insubstantial amount.
Because you sold Jace.
Sold him a
player. I forgot to bring the oversized version with me. I should have.
I found that using the oversized version made everyone be like, oh, wow, John has 7 loyalty tokens on his commander. Might as well do something about that.
Are you all done after that, Janelle?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay.
I'm just shuffling.
So you can go take a turn.
Okay.
Woo!
All my creatures had summoning sickness.
Yeah.
On tap. Man. Making me freaking make hard choices here.
Yeah.
Hard choices are tough. That's why they're hard.
It's true.
It is true.
Alright, let's do this. Tapping my 5 lands for 6 mana, thanks to the Karu. And busting out the Argentum Armor, which would allow me to equip the creature +6/+6.
Yeah.
And whenever equipped creature attacks, destroy target permanent. And the equipped cost is 6.
Or a Nahiri Uptick.
Oh!
Oh, I'm glad you didn't realize that before.
Really? Oh, no. Well, I can't even cast Nahiri now because she costs 7.
Guess what's happening next turn. Make a soldier. Equip this. Give him Swiftfoot Boots.
Look, I've got the weakest board state.
You passing the turn?
You're passing the turn. My board state is so weak.
Nobody really has a board state.
You know who else had a weak board state? Josh.
Yeah, but now I didn't kill anybody's Planeswalker. Other than that one attack on Janelle, I really haven't done anything.
I know, Newton. I'm well aware.
For those 2 points. Those 2 flying double strike points.
If I die by 2 points in this game, you know whose fault it was.
Unexpected draw.
Surprise.
Yeah. When John Bolding starts like singing when he's not even on my team. It worries me.
Pretty soon we'll be able to understand the pitch of when he's drawn Cyclonic Rift. It's like, oh, guess that's Cyclonic Rift.
Soon.
Suddenly, John like sits up in his chair and.
All right, look.
It's probably like a subtle art to like body language in Commander.
It's like poker. Yeah. You just gotta read the other guys, see what they're thinking.
Oh, did John finally draw something that wasn't mana?
What is your creature, Justin?
A 3/7 haste hexproof with extort.
Okay.
Is that the guy that gives everybody else extort?
Indeed.
What? You got to recast them?
So I played a card that's called Dread Return. Okay. It is 2BB. Return target creature card from a graveyard to the battlefield, and it has flashback, which is sacrifice 3 key creatures, and I can recast it.
Damn. That's terrible.
And Pontiff seemed a little bit better than my Disciple or Flesh Carver.
Oy vey. I hate decisions. Do you guys know what that's like?
I'm paralyzed and racked by indecision.
I'm surprised you have any decision, given how you've played land basically every turn. He's and mana rocks and nothing else.
It's rough. It's just a rough life to live.
Although, can't you sack the Hedron at some point for a card?
I can to draw 3.
Yeah. That's not a bad.
Yeah, it's actually pretty slick. So I'm going to tap 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
That's a lot.
To play Teferi. Okay.
That makes more sense.
Ooh, hey.
Tick up Teferi.
To do your card thing. Card thing.
Cards, why do you exist? And where does that put us? I've got 9 mana on the board. My life is really hard. All right, I'm gonna play. Tap 2 to play Thassa, God of the Sea.
God of the Sea!
So Thassa is a legendary enchantment creature. It's indestructible. As long as my devotion to 2 is less, blue is less than 5, Thassa's instant creature. My devotion to blue is 5. But at the beginning of my upkeep, I scry 1, and I can pay 1 and a blue so that target creature I control can't be blocked this turn.
Sadness.
That's
crap, man.
You're crap. You're not crap. I'd never say that about you. Just want you to know that.
Thassa.
Oh, my goodness. And then I'm going to tap Thran Dynamo to sacrifice Dreamstone Hedron and draw 3 cards.
No!
And then I will pass the turn to Justin.
All right.
No.
Justin.
That's crazy. You drew, 6 cards that turn? No, 7.
I didn't draw many cards at all.
It makes me really sad that as the green deck, I have the least mana. Other than the white deck.
Yeah,
The Bowl of Conference is a big upgrade for this deck.
I only have 8 mana.
I'm sucking.
Let's.
That's not.
I'm like, please give me the mana.
How big is your lieutenant dude?
He's a 7/7.
7/7, okay.
Is that the hexproof dude?
Yes, he's also hexproof.
Wow. Let's do 3. 4, 5, or 3. I guess before we do that. No, that probably doesn't make sense. We can do that, yeah. We're gonna play Black Sun Zenith. Put X -1/-1 counters on each creature. X is 7. Oh, actually get 1 cheaper.
That affects Hexproof as well?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's not because it doesn't target.
Mm. Boo.
Doesn't say target on it. It just says all.
Oh, you shuffle into your library, huh?
Yep. All the Zenith cycle, right back into the library.
X minus
my Pontifical Blazer.
Can you actually tell me what the wording is? Is that if it would go into your library or your graveyard, shuffle back into your
deck? No, it's just then
shuffle. It's just
shuffle. As part of resolution, you shuffle it.
Just checking.
Mm-hmm. And
there's
then,
no if and conditional to it. It just always goes back in the deck.
We'll tap
Cabal. Unless someone counters it.
Okay.
And then it will go in the graveyard.
11, which is actually convenient, which is actually how much Up Next List costs.
So your Pontiff doesn't die?
No, he's a 2/7, but blue Bad Moon makes him one bigger.
I see.
So he's an 0/1 right now.
0/1?
Yep. No. Just barely survives.
Oh, because of Black Sun. Yep. Got it.
So we're gonna lose 2 life. A demon to play. We'll pay one to move the boots over, and then we're going to attack you for 5, or 6, Newton. 6.
And is it my turn?
Yep. I'm all done after that.
Yeah. Oh, who has 4 cards in their hand?
I definitely have that many.
No, I've got more.
Probably all of us. Yeah, because John just drew cards and Newton's been slow rolling his hand.
Where did I put that wolf? Is it in my graveyard? What the fuck?
So you get wolves equal to the number of
players who have 4 more cards in their hand. And I just lost one of my tokens. Where did I put it?
Drew a big one. There's.
What the fuck?
Okay. So we gotta get under 4.
Or just keep wiping them like Justin keeps doing. They're not, like, huge.
I wouldn't mind if I could get rid of Beastmaster Ascension, but I can't. That's black is only good at one thing. Killing cards, killing creatures, and discard. And paying life for things.
Paying life. Oh, man.
If I had another card slot, I would have tried to put an Oblivion Stone in this deck as well, just as another way to wipe everything away. You can also do Perilous Vault. That's another colorless sweeper for everything.
Wipe it away, wipe it away, keep wiping it away.
I don't have much.
That's my theme song.
Both of those creatures on the board are hexproof, right? This one's hexproof?
Yes.
Because it's equipped with the other thing.
Mm-hmm.
And that guy's hexproof naturally?
No, the other guy's dead.
That's Teferi.
Oh, what is that again?
The Kraken? He's dead. That's just my Planeswalker.
Oh, I thought that was a creature out on the field. Sorry.
No, Justin did that -7/-7 thing to kill all of my big creatures.
I even killed Thassa.
Okay, and he's 7/7.
You killed
Thassa
like a dick.
No, he's an 0/1 right now. These are -1/-1 counters. Because Black Sun Zenith gives it to everybody.
Forever.
So, yes.
Okay.
They just have -1/-1 counters
on
them. So my Pontiff has been significantly become smaller.
Thwacketed.
So I'm gonna pay 3 to cast Renrun's Packmaster.
Okay.
That's the I can't cast that. Never mind. Shoot. I need to sacrifice off to cast that.
Oh, because it's got a champion.
Mm-hmm. Guess I'll cast my Planeswalker.
Cast that Planeswalker. Woo! Back onto the battlefield.
Planeswalker!
And you pay the extra 4?
Yeah.
Okay. Dice.
Need the dice. 3. And then I'm gonna...
You blow up Argent tomorrow.
It's a sweet idea.
I was actually thinking of that, to be honest with you.
I got nobody to equip it on!
You could also blow up my Bad Moon, which kills the Pontiff. Which would be
blow
funny.
Up. You see, that's a 2/2 right there. That's what you need to
do. Yeah, I mean, the Pontiff's just gonna die at some point, anyways.
You should blow up the Bad Moon. That's actually a sweet
idea. Yeah, except Newton gets to make the play where, like, he gets to
blow
up.
I'll talk to you, John.
Yeah.
Anything.
I'm either gonna blow up the Agentum Armor, the Black Moon.
Okay.
Or that stupid hexproof artifact.
Oh.
I have three options.
Well.
Predator flagship.
I'm afraid of the Argentum armor, but I feel like it's not a threat yet.
Well, he gets to go.
It's gonna come out and it's gonna swing and it's gonna hit one of us for like seven.
He also gets to just blow up anything he wants.
If he swings with it.
He can just blow up anything he wants with it?
That's what Argentum armor is.
Can I read this?
Yeah. When it attacks, it's destroy target permanent.
Mm-hmm. An annihilator.
Yeah, but you get to pick. You just get to
so
like,
it can he can be like attack Justin and destroy
I'm gonna have to destroy that.
Yeah, you just get to vindicate every turn.
No, don't do it.
There's
just
certain cards that need to go.
It's
don't,
gone.
Dad, no,
it's over.
Don't
There's
do it.
Don't do it. You can also just get it back if you commander.
Don't do it, Janelle's. Don't.
And then.
You see, because he's red, actually, I could put it back.
It takes a lot of resources. You have to tick down Nahiri, then recast it.
Oh, to my hand, yeah.
John,
yeah.
You have no creatures, right?
Oh, man, yeah. I just went
I do not have any creatures. Really I do have an untapped blue mana, blue spells I control, cost one less to cast, and I have seven cards in my hand.
Okay. This is going to be really dumb, but I can't do anything else, and I have all this mana. So I'm going to pay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You tap your 0/1, make it have flying.
Does that cost 5? That costs 7 in total.
Yeah, I have 2 more.
Oh, okay.
I was getting there.
Oh, sure.
I was just doing it.
I like that. So wait a minute, that's pretty.
You didn't destroy your Gentle Armor yet.
She did.
Yeah, I did.
Oh, you did? Oh, okay, got
yeah,
it.
Yeah, she destroyed it with her Planeswalker.
Yeah, well, with my Planeswalker. That's okay. Why I didn't cast anything. Her negative ability is destroy an artifact or enchantment.
Got it.
And then I'm done.
Okay.
That's all I have to do. You know I'm reaching when that's what I did. Like,
I mean, it's still 7 mana kill any creature, pretty much.
But it was like a 0/1, really.
I wish I had creatures still.
You also can do that at instant speed. There was no reason, like, if you
didn't necessarily need to do it still.
You could have waited until, like...
You know what? I honestly forgot that I could do that at instant
yeah.
speed. It was a complete mental...
Marble diamond.
I'm sure nothing better than a.
You know, sometimes you're just, like, reaching for something to do.
I mean, I had to do the same thing. It was like, oh, I suddenly have Cabal Coffers and a lot of mana. I guess I'm playing all of these things.
That doesn't sound like reaching, though. It just sounds like having things to do.
I really miss Thassa, God of the Sea.
He was nice for like.
Yeah, she was around for like half a turn.
I wish I had been able to even scry a single card with her ability.
Yeah. I know how that goes.
Let's be friends, Newton.
Yeah, sure.
Let's be sad friends.
Sad friends.
Here on this end of the board, where good things don't happen.
I've done absolutely nothing
just
this entire game.
With you.
I'm like literally sitting here trying to do a thing, and everyone's like, nope.
Well, we did kind of all blitz Josh into the ground.
Okay.
Yeah, it was worth it, though. I'm not gonna lie.
Put a silver blade pot in down and equip them with this swift of boots to keep them alive for a turn.
All right.
And he's not a soldier. Kind of a bummer, but okay. And that's it.
Oh, is he a knight?
Yeah.
Yeah. All to you, John.
That's really it, huh?
Yeah. Yep.
Untap all them islands. Draw a card.
Draw cards.
Tick up to fairy. Okay.
What you gonna do?
Things.
Tap Urgul's Eye to play Mind Stone, which is, you guessed it,
a mana rock.
Yay, Mind Stone.
Another mana rock.
I can sacrifice for a draw.
I just had one of those. I sacrificed it.
Yeah.
Well, it's Justin gets any more mana. He
it's a good time.
My explosion.
Okay. Then I am going to tap 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to play Breaching Leviathan.
Ooh.
Tapping every non-blue creature on the field.
My demon's already tapped.
I'm a whale.
Woo. Do they stay untapped or?
They do not untap during their controller's next untap steps.
Oh, that's sweet. That would have been good to play my damn Sunburst Angel.
That's mean.
It was.
They're just like
Sunblast.
Blow everything up.
Tap Mind Stone to play Soul Ring.
Yay!
Because I don't know about you guys, but I don't have enough mana rocks.
More rocks. Yeah. What's up?
Nothing really.
And then I am going to tap 4 and play Assault Suit on Breaching Leviathan.
What does that do?
I'm playing it, sorry.
Fun thing.
Playing it, and then I am tapping 3 to equip it. Breaching Leviathan is now an 11-11 with haste. It cannot attack me or planeswalkers I control and cannot be sacrificed. At the beginning of each opponent's upkeep, I may give that player Breaching Leviathan until the end of their turn untapped, which is an 11-11 with haste.
Yeah.
And then it's going to punch Justin for 11.
Ow.
40. That's a big punch.
You want to give it to me, right?
I am going to give it to you.
Hey!
As I pass the turn to you.
All right. You don't have to, like, physically...
Yeah, it untaps, though. So here's your 11-11 with haste,
yep.
Untapped.
Why? Because
it can't attack me.
Because, yeah, there's no downside.
So you can... I'm sorry, I missed that part of the description.
So Assault Suit lets you give your creature to another player at the beginning of their turn until the end of their turn.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
Then it comes back to me.
Gotcha.
It goes to them untapped... It's an 11-11. Everyone's creatures are tapped. It seems hilarious.
That is hilarious.
It also can't be sacrificed.
So we're gonna play Demon of Wailing Agonies. Oh, this guy is still tapped.
Yes.
He does not untap.
He will not untap.
As long as you control your commander, Demon of Wailing Agonies gets +2/+2, and whatever Demon of Wailing Agonies deals combat damage to a player, that player sacrifices a creature.
There's Justin's lieutenant.
We're gonna equip the boots.
Let's go through this turn. Das Boot.
Das Boots.
Das Boot.
We will attack Newton with our assault suit guy and our 6677 flyer.
That is 18 to Newton.
And of course I'm tapped out.
Yep. And you're gonna lose your your dude there.
So I'm down to 5. What dude? What dude am I losing?
When this guy deals combat damage to you, you have to sacrifice a creature.
I see. Okay. This was brutal.
I guess we'll tick up Omnixilis. Everybody loses one life. I gain that much.
One life?
Or 39. Yes. That's all I got.
Okay, who has 4 more cards in their hand?
And then...
I do.
Is it every player's?
Oh yeah! So oh, Janelle, yeah. You now have control of an 11-11 with haste.
Woo!
That can't attack me.
Do you get to choose if it gets to me? Or?
I do.
Yeah.
Okay. So let me just do this really quick. I'm gonna start getting confused. So all 3 of you have 4 cards, correct?
Yes.
So I have 3 tapped, 3 untapped, just for reference.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have another. I lost my token, it's so sad.
I have a robot armored giant whale. Just for the record, just thought everyone might want to know.
Ha ha! Thank you.
I will. Oops.
Three. Okay. So I have a... I didn't draw a card. So I'm going to draw a card. An 11-11-A.
Yeah, you're right, chat. They gain control of the creature, but John still has control of the equipment. So you can't, like...
Correct.
You can't move the equipment while you have control of the creature.
Yeah. Or, like, you also can't... It's worded you can't, like, kill the equipment so that you get to keep the creature or any shenanigans.
Yeah,
like that.
The way they've worded it is, like, a little weird, but it works around all of the, like, weird scenarios where you could, like, try to, like, sacrifice it for some effect.
So I'm going to take up for Elise.
Make elf.
And make an elf, which I will then immediately sacrifice.
What? That's
cast
so grim.
Red's Rung Pathmaster.
She's just making, she's...
Dude, can you imagine how brutal that is? Hey, call so-and-so.
Also...
stab him in the face.
Also, I just want to point out, I'm really sad, I did not have enough foil basic swaps.
So you have three
like,
non-foil?
There's like one or two, like not... No, these ones are foil, but like this one's in the center. It's like, oh...
So that's mine now?
It's an 11-11.
Sweet.
For this turn, yeah.
Which practically makes it mine.
It's mine forever.
So what you said was, it's mine.
Yeah.
I shouldn't attack Newton with it.
Oh my.
You should attack Newton.
I was actually going to attack Justin with it.
It's a sweet-ass idea.
You may not have it if you attack me. Just saying. You should attack Newton instead.
It's not hers. What does she care?
I'm gonna attack Justin with it.
Woo! Is that the only attacker you're declaring, or are you attacking with other stuff?
Sorry, I should do this.
She doesn't have anything else that's not summoning sick.
Oh.
Because her wolves are still tied down.
Right. Sorry.
From it coming into play.
I like how we've kept Janelle from attacking because of Beastmaster Ascension.
It gets real dumb.
I'm on board.
I've
got
says,
my respective Ascension in my deck.
Put a 6/6 into play. Use white bordered lands.
I think I own some white bordered lands.
Yeah, chat was saying if you want to be really annoying, use white bordered lands.
So I'm going to attack you with it, Justin.
All right, well, we're forced to do this. We're going to annihilate it. Destroy target, non black creature. It can't be regenerated. Draw a card.
All right. I got rid of an annihilate. Boop.
His only annihilate.
Oh, the Gentle
suit's hanging out.
Yeah, the suit doesn't go away.
I just wish I could put it on Thassa, God of the Sea, but I can't.
No.
And then
the combo I was going for was put it out and then
I do anything?
Save mana so I could make it unblockable on turns as I gave it to people. But Justin ruined that.
Oh.
You're welcome.
That's so evil. Dude. Dude, that's wrong.
So I'm gonna make more wolves.
Okay.
Puppies.
All the puppies.
And I don't know, I guess I'm gonna pay two and kill your demon, Justin.
I think it's a good idea.
Well, someone keeps killing all my creatures, so I can't fucking attack anybody.
It hasn't
I haven't been
me.
Able to attack anybody yet. It's driving me crazy.
I know, for the first time, it hasn't been me.
Okay. And then after I get my wolves, I'm done. This doesn't untap, so I guess I'll take up these guys.
Okay.
And then I am done.
You're all right. Get him, Newton.
Let's see. Dropped.
Ooh. Get out. What?
Chat says, lulz, Newton is the only person to not get to use the giant armored robotic whale.
Yeah, that's messed up, isn't it?
I barely got to use it, if that means anything.
All right.
It accomplished its purpose, which was
all right.
Find out what other people were holding.
I'm pretty sure it's a GP, not a PTQ chat this weekend in Baltimore. I wish I was going, but unfortunately it was not in the cards. I'm going to hit a couple like preliminary PTQs here in the area.
What? Wow, that's crazy. All right. Oh, sorry. What am I gonna do?
What's it like, Newton?
I am going to...
You, for the record, I don't know if anyone has noticed this. Newton has gotten completely mana screwed this game.
Yeah, he's not
He hasn't lot. Complained about it once. He's been such a good sport.
So I will bring her back out.
Oh.
Yeah.
Tick her up for a core soldier.
Yeah, let's go core soldier.
Make a 1/1.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry, Newton.
Yeah.
It's your turn, John.
Oh. Is it my turn now?
Wait, there.
Yeah, you put your core soldier.
Yeah.
Okay, and then I will.
It gets the swift.
Yeah, yeah, let's go. Let's do it.
You should punch somebody in the nose
Woo!
With it.
All right. And then
when that guy attacks, he goes woo.
That's right. And then I pass the turn.
I'm so sorry.
It's all right. It happens.
It does happen.
It happens.
It just doesn't always happen so thoroughly. All right. Ticking Teferi up. Doing the Teferi thing. Boo.
No, I don't think Newton's... You haven't had to discard it all yet, Newton, right?
No.
Yeah. He's been fine.
I mean, yeah, I've been...
Fine enough that he hasn't had to, like,
yeah.
be, like, pitching his hands, but...
No.
He's got enough mana in play to, like, do things. He just doesn't have, like, the... He doesn't have, like, the overwhelming amount of mana that, like...
Allows me to do a combo to put several things down.
Yeah, because, like, John has a whole bunch of mana rocks in play. I have a Kowal Coffers. Janelle has, like, Harrowed and...
her elves.
Yeah, and she just, like, makes... Yeah,
and I had a land that got me two lands.
Yeah.
So it wasn't that... Honestly, if I didn't have the fetch,
yeah,
I would have the same amount of lands as you have. Yeah.
Hey, but you know.
Yeah, what you really want, I think land tax is too expensive, but it's a really good white commander card.
Yeah.
It's just like, you put it into play and it's just like, does someone have more lands than me? I'm gonna go find some lands.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's not a bad idea, honestly. So. I'm gonna tap Thran Dynamo to play Commander Seer to sack Commander Seer to draw a card.
Woo!
God damn it. Do things, cards. I'm gonna tap four to play Stitcher Gerolf.
What does he do?
Yay!
Stitcher Gerolf is a 3/4 creature, human wizard. Pay two and a blue, tap him, and each player puts the top three cards of his or her library into his or her graveyard.
Got it.
Exile up to two creature cards put into graveyards this way. Put an XX blue zombie creature token onto the battlefield where X is the total power of the creatures exiled this way.
So he does all that.
He makes zombies.
Okay.
Yeah.
Out of your stuff.
Got it.
And my stuff, but mostly your stuff. And he has a tap ability, but I cannot use that.
Mm-hmm. Give him a salt suit, and then he can use it.
He's a 3/4. I could give him a salt suit, and then he could use it, which is something I'm presently considering. Because it sounds really funny. All right. So I'm going to then... Tap three to give him a salt suit.
I will respond.
Okay.
He's responding.
How big are the zombies he makes?
They are XXs, where X is the total power of two cards that were exiled through his exile power.
Okay.
And you basically pick two cards.
From all of the cards that get exiled.
Got it.
We're going to make 12 mana with Kowal Coffers.
Okay.
I'm going to cycle a Decree of Pain. So
what does that do?
All till end of turn, all creatures get -2/-2.
No.
End of turn.
Okay.
I'm gonna draw a card.
Wait, did you just cast that?
Yes.
Okay.
So all creatures on the board get -2/-2.
So I'm gonna do something in response.
Okay.
Okay.